Dr. Mohammed Wael graduated from Arabian Gulf University in 2016. He completed his internship at King Hamad University Hospital in 2017. He then joined the Internal Medicine Department and is currently a registrar and R3 resident in the Saudi board. He also is currently a chief resident, resident representatives. Tafadhal, Doctor.
Thank you, Aisha, very much. Thank you for the organizing committee for having me today. It's an honor to participate and help the grade six and medical students and interns choose their careers. And I'm very, very glad because I remember myself being part of this committee when it first started 4 or 5 years ago. And it's a great pleasure to be back as a presenter. Just 1 second, I'll share my slides. All right, so before I begin speaking about internal medicine, I'll just like to say a few points about choosing your career or specialty. Being a doctor is more than just a service or a job. It involves great responsibility, commitment, and above all, heart of service. So whatever the field you decide, whatever the specialty you decide to go for, always remember that you need to be committed 100%, because in medicine, especially in clinical medicine, we're talking about patients' lives and health. And it's very important to take care of them as they are one of our family members, because if any one of our family members, God forbid, got admitted or something, we would want the best care. So if any take-home message from this whole session is that whatever specialty you decide to go for, be committed to it 100%. Choose a field that you're passionate about, in which you can give more than 180%. It was a tough road being a medical student, and I congratulate you all for reaching to this point, but this is only the beginning. You have many, many, many options. Joining medical school does not mean that you need to be a clinician. And I thank all the previous presenters for presenting all the various options. You can be a researcher, you can be in health management, you can be a clinician, an academic, you can be in health management, public health. There are many, many options. Don't feel pressured to be only a clinician. Do what feels right to you. Experiment. Yani make use of your internship year, as all the presenters mentioned previously. Try to live the internship year as a resident. Be active. Be part of the rounds. Be part of a team. Consider doing service years, even if it is not in your country or not in your hospital. If you're not sure about your specialty, it's never wrong to do a service here. And always, always remember, it's never too late to take a step backwards. So if you join something and you don't feel that this is your place, don't feel that this is the end, this is my only route. Because if you think about it, your career, inshallah, will be 40, 50, maybe 60 years. So what's 1, 2 years or 3 years even in comparison to 40 years of your career? So always, always be sure to be in the right place for you. So talking about internal medicine, as per the American College of Physicians, in 2009, they defined it as physicians for adults. In 2011, they broadened the physician definition to be physicians who specialize in prevention, detection, and treatment of illnesses in adults. And in 2013, a very detailed definition was made, in which it said that we are specialists who apply scientific knowledge and clinical expertise to the diagnosis, treatment, and compassionate care. Put 100 lines under the word compassionate, across the spectrum from health to complex illnesses. And the main reason I put this slide is to highlight that we all need to administer compassionate care to our patients. So why internal medicine? Number one, internal medicine covers the main systems of the body, and it's a bridge to diverse subspecialties, ranging from endocrine, infectious disease, to cardiology, gastroenterology, pulmonology, and it's beyond the scope of this lecture to come into each and every subspecialty. But one of the major advantages of internal medicine is that you have a lot of options in the future. Plus, it includes, it involves both clinical judgment and critical thinking, in which you assess your patient, you get to think about differential diagnosis, you get to order investigations accordingly, and treat your patients accordingly. And at the same time, it involves procedures, including scopes, for example, or interventional cardiology. Not to undermine any other specialty, but internal medicine are usually consulted by almost everyone in the hospital, ranging from the surgical to the gynecology to the emergency to the critical care. Internal medicine are always needed to help in the hospital. Furthermore, as in other specialities, there is always room to help in academic services and teach the younger generations in order to help them become doctors in the future. And finally, it's a rewarding specialty. I still do remember a personal experience that until this day affected me a lot. I was involved and part of the resuscitation team in a patient who had cardiac arrest. Thankfully, we were able to achieve ROSC. And 2 months later, the daughter ran into me and she remembered me and she thanked me very well. And she was very glad that that her mother was able to join them again to the Friday gatherings. And till this day, this is one of the most rewarding feelings. And when I heard the prayers of her, I was thankful that I was part of that team and that I joined medicine as a whole. So as I said previously, huge, huge numbers of options of subspecialties, and the number of subspecialties and super subspecialties are increasing by the day. This is a list taken from USA. There is a list of American board certified subspecialties and even some subspecialties that were started in the USA and still not certified. Internal medicine has a wide scope of services. We cover inpatients, do rounds on them, and of course, ranging from all the different subspecialties from general medicine to the various subspecialties. And of course, as internal medicine, we do rotate on all of these subspecialties. We cover clinics, including general medicine clinics, and again, subspecialized clinics. We cover consultations from all over the hospital. We run codes, cardiac arrest code or SALS code, which is known as code blue in my hospital, King Hamad University Hospital, and even code stroke, in which patients who might benefit from acute treatment of stroke, there is a code for them for us to administer thrombolysis and or arrange for thrombectomy. Of course, during on-calls, we cover emergency and we see cases in the emergency. There are procedures that might be done. There are minor procedures for us to do as a resident. Plus then there are the complex procedures which are done by the subspecialized physicians. And finally, we can be involved in critical care, either as a subspecialty after we're done with the board, or even currently when we cover on-calls, we are usually the bridge between internal medicine and critical care. For example, if a patient is hypotensive, we are usually the first line to be called, we resuscitate the patient, and if we fail, then the case is escalated to ICU. So number of procedures are involved in internal medicine. It can be from draining pleural fluid to abdominal paracentesis for ascites, to subspecialties like cardiac catheterization, to endoscopic procedures in gastroenterology, to bronchoscopy and respiratory, to kidney biopsy and nephrology, and the list goes on. So briefly speaking about internal medicine at KHUH, since my experience is from there, usually the work is 5 days a week from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m., Sunday to Thursday, on average 5 to 6 calls per month, may reach to 7 calls at times of shortage. And currently the main shortage is in registrars. The juniors are getting 5 to 6 calls. Calls are usually 24 hours. We have a supportive head of department and consultants. They're always here to back us up, and they help us in research opportunities, as was mentioned in the previous lectures, because research is very important. Number one, for your CV. Number two, for you to join the board, and even for the future when you're planning for your fellowship. The current residency accredited in internal medicine is the Saudi board, and internal medicine is a 4-year program. Of course, neurology is a separate program of 5 years. Otherwise, all the medical subspecialties are included in the internal medicine board, after which you can subspecialize when you finish. The usual norm in King Hamad is that you need to do at least 1 year of service before joining the board and before the administration agreeing to sponsor you. I personally see it as an advantage, because I remember as an intern, I had a doubt between two specialties. And when I decided to join internal medicine and after the service year, I knew that this was the place for me. And after that, I joined the board, and thankfully I'm currently doing my R3. As I mentioned previously, there is a lot of research opportunities. Plus, one advantage I find at King Hamad Hospital is that during your board, you can do rotations outside, because not some subspecialties are not still credited in King Hamad. So you get the option to do it either in Salmania, BDF, or even in one of the tertiary hospitals in Saudi Arabia. And this gives you the benefit of seeing different schools, different hospitals, and how things are applied in each. So the hierarchy of positions, first you start as a senior house officer or a junior resident, then you get promoted to a registrar. Then when you finish the board and get, I think, 2 years experience, you become a senior registrar. And finally, after completing your fellowship and a certain number of years of experience, you become a consultant. During your training, make sure that you finish your exams. If you're in the Saudi board, you're expected to finish part one by the end of year one or year two of your training, and part two by the end of year four. Be sure that whatever board you join or whatever specialty you decide to join, is that you need to prepare for your fellowship. Be involved in quality projects, be involved in research. For example, if you're planning to go to the UK for fellowship, make sure that you finish your MRCPs. If you're in surgery, make sure that you finish your MRCS. And whatever country you're deciding to go to or program, make sure that you start preparing at least from year two or year three, so that by the time you're done, you have the advantage of having everything prepared. So since we're talking about COVID-19 and the era of COVID-19, I'll just quickly give a summary about how COVID-19 affected our training. Usually we used to have yearly exams, which were canceled. In Saudi board, we get half academic day in which the residents get half a day off for lectures from consultants and by senior residents, and it was converted to Zoom. We continued the morning report and CME again via Zoom. Outside rotations were kept on hold, but thankfully they were resumed a few months back, and all clinics were converted into telemedicine clinics, and again they were resumed 2 or 3 months back. I will not lie, and I guess this applies to every single specialty. At times you'll feel burned out. At times you'll feel that this is too much and you're overwhelmed. You're not able to balance between your studies, your work, your on calls, your social life, which is very, very important. And again, I have to say that you need to continue and leave a space for your social life. But at the end of the day, if you're in the right place, if you love what you do, it will pass. And as all of you were able to finish medical school with all its hardships and obstacles, I'm sure that everyone will be able to pass the residency and inshallah become consultants. Last piece of advice, make use of your internship. Be part of the team, be an active member, involve yourself in researches, make your name known to the supervising team, show that you are present. It's not just about being present in the rounds and writing up notes. Make sure you finish your exams. If you're planning to do the Saudi board, finish your SMLE. If you're planning to go to the US, do your USMLE and et cetera. Keep your options open. For example, if you're planning to go to the US, also do your Saudi to have a backup plan. It's very important not to stick yourself in only one tunnel, but to keep your options open so that you make use of the time. Finally, keep looking. The only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking never settle. This is by Steve Jobs. And I truly believe in this quote. If you don't find yourself where you are, change your specialty once, twice. It doesn't matter. At the end of the day, you need to find the place that is right for you. Thank you all for listening and having me today. It was a great pleasure. And if there are any questions, please let me know. And feel free to ask me at any time through email or through WhatsApp, through my phone number.
Thank you, Dr. Mohammed, for the great presentation. If anyone has any question, please provide it in the chat.
Okay, I see a question. When does KHOH open their residency application process? Usually to apply for the service year, they open multiple times during the year. You just need to check the website or speak to the training department. And after that, if there are vacancies, they will have you to interview. And once the you are accepted, inshallah, you will start working in the hospital. Then regarding residency program, it goes along the Saudi board schedule. So the application is usually in January, and you do the Saudi board application, plus your the program director of whatever department you're working of will be aware, so that they agree for your sponsorship or not. Okay, there's another question. Is ICU part of internal medicine? There is a different board for ICU in the Saudi board. However, as internal medicine physicians, after you're done with the board, you can do a fellowship in critical care and pulmonology. I think there is some subspecialties that includes critical care, and internal medicine can join to them. Okay, there's another question. Is fellowship necessary for being a consultant in general medicine? To be honest, I'm not sure 100%, but I think you need to check the Nahra regulations, because in Bahrain, we follow Nahra. So it's very important to check with them. I got another question. Could you please explain what is a service year? A service year is basically a year in which you joined a particular department in the hospital, whether it's internal medicine, emergency, ICU, ophthalmology, whatever. And you're part of the team, you're rotating on the different teams, but you're not in a training program. So it's a 1 year contract, and by the end of the contract, you either renew or you join a program or you quit and join another place. Okay, benefit of doing a residency in Bahrain versus Western countries. To be honest, this is a very, very broad topic, and it needs a huge lecture by itself. And it depends on the person, to be honest. It depends on your priorities. It depends on your personal life. It depends on what do you want to do in your career. And for example, personally, one of my plans was to go to US and do my residency there, but due to family issues, I decided to stay back in Bahrain. I never regret it. I'm happy where I am. But to give you a fair answer, you need to check with people who did in the Western countries. You need to check people who did residency in Bahrain and compare. With regards to whether the training in Bahrain is good, to be honest, I'm happy with my training. I feel that I'm going in a steady way. And at the end of the day, don't forget that there is a fellowship. You'll go abroad to complete your subspecialty. Do we get paid during the service year? Yes, according to your level, you'll get paid. For example, if you're a senior house officer, which is a junior resident, you'll get paid as a junior resident. Then I have another question. Is there placement opportunity for foreigner with MRCP degree? What are the requirements? I think there is, but you have to confirm with the administration of the hospital. I'm not sure, to be honest. I'm not sure if you're asking about King Hamad or other hospitals. You need to confirm with Nahra about what degree you'll be qualified to. And I think also check with the administration. Did we get paid in the service year? Yes, I did get paid in the service year. Again, at the salary of a junior resident. Any other questions from anyone? Hassan, I think we're done with the questions. I hope I didn't miss anything.
يعطيك العافية دكتور على presentation. كان مفيد جدا.
Thank you so much. Okay, it's a pleasure for us to have you, doctor, with us. Now we will be having a break till 3:45, and we will start with the UK board. Plus, we will send a link in the chat box. It includes all the presentations of today. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for having me, and thank you all. Thank you.